Good morning, brothers and sisters. I need to travel different places. As I travel to different places, oftentimes I bring some books with me so I can read while I was traveling. So I wonder, when you are on your trip, what type of books you will bring? Would you bring some novel with you? It's many Chinese like to read Kung Fu novel. It's quite regretful if you don't have a chance to read the novel. For there's a particular author, his name is Jin, and he is very skillful in terms of writing novel plots. And you can see a lot of excitement from his books. And we, as we read it, we like to practice Kung Fu alongside with the story. And yet we realize it is impossible to learn from it. As you see the main characters in one of his novels, and we see there's a male character and female character in the novel. And we also see one particular character in one of his novel. Also different characters in the other novel. Actually, I read them all. And also one official in, character in one of his novels. It's quite difficult to translate as we translate the Chinese novel name into English. The reason why we are so attracted to his writing is because of how he described the characters in the novel. So what does it mean that he can put a very vivid description of different roles in the novel? It's actually when we are reading it, we somehow put ourselves into the role of the character themselves. And somehow we can identify ourselves into the story. And as the person going through different plots, and it seems like how I am in the story going through different plots as well. So as I read the novel, I realize I myself was actually in the story going through different experiences. So as the person turning into as a hero, all of a sudden I feel like I am the hero. As I'm going there to kill all the evil people, I realize I'm the righteous one. I feel like I'm reading my own story. But do you know our Bible is also a very popular book? The reason why, one of the reasons why the Bible is so popular, it is also that it can bring us, the readers, into the story. All of a sudden, we can identify ourselves as the sinners. Or I'm a traveler, sojourner of the earth. And if I'm a sinner, then I need a savior. And the Bible tells us that Jesus is the Savior. He is the Messiah. As I read the Bible, I realize I can identify the characters in the story. I'm part of the story. Just like I am just an ordinary person. And all of a sudden, as I put myself into the story, all of a sudden, I myself become a hero. I feel this way as I can identify myself in the Bible stories. I myself is merely an ordinary man. And I realized that before I believed in the Lord, I was an ordinary man. And after I accept the Lord, I'm still an ordinary man. And this is the reason why I can in tune with the Bible story. I truly love reading the Bible. For I can identify myself into the characters in the scripture. And this is my topic for my sermon today, is that God can use an ordinary man. The passage we just read is from Acts chapter 9, from verse 10 to verse 20. And right here, we can see two characters. One is Paul, or Saul, and Ananias. And from here, we can see there are 3 points. One is before Paul's life has been transformed. And then during the middle point is how Paul's life being changed and was led by a particular person. And certainly that how we can learn from Paul's life transformation. First, let us look at how Paul's life has been how the transformation of Paul's life. As we read from verse 10 to verse 20, and therefore right now I would like to share with you the story before how Paul has been changed. Perhaps many of us are very familiar with the passage. We realize Paul was Saul before, and he was creating threats to the believers. And not only that, he got official permission in order to arrest Christians. He He knew there were a lot of Christians resides in the land of Damascus, and therefore he was on his way to go there to arrest the Christians. When he was on his way, he saw a big light. And as we experienced, we have experienced a heavy fog a few days ago. Oh, and I was traveling down from Montreal all the way down to New York. As you can imagine, where the forest fire started in Canada, so I was traveling with the fire dust. And however, Paul has seen a big light in the story here. And not only he has seen a big light, there's a voice coming out of the light saying, "Paul, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" Of course, Saul has no idea who was speaking. And the voice continues saying, "I am Jesus whom you are persecuting." As Paul went blind, he couldn't see anything, and someone led him into Damascus. So for 3 days, Paul, Saul didn't eat or sleep. As you can see, Paul has experienced something extraordinary. And as we see, this is similar to some novel. It built up some excitement as we going through the story. As Paul's intention was trying to arrest people, now he is blind. He experienced a big change in his life. So let us change the camera lens back then to our days now. As we are reading the scripture before us, as we read out the scripture on our hand, we realize as we read the New Testament for this 27 books of New Testament, besides the four Gospels, we realize half of the New Testament besides the Gospel were written by Paul. As we read the writing by Paul, we realize he is an extraordinary person. Someone even say Christianity is actually started by Paul. For Paul has developed the thinking and doctrine from Jesus' teaching. Many things of the main doctrine of Christianity, such as justification by faith and divine view and understanding of church, it's all from the writing of Paul. And through his writing, the understanding of this religion was changed and transformed from a Jewish-based religion into the Gentiles' to the whole world.
而且当我们从这里看的时候，我们看到他本来叫扫罗，现在变成保罗。
As we read the scripture, we realize Saul was named Saul, and was, his name was changed to Paul.
新约的扫罗，你知道旧约的扫罗是谁啊？
So as we realize, there is a person named Saul in the New Testament. Do you know who else was named Saul back then in the Old Testament?
因为旧约的扫罗就是扫罗王。
For back then, in the Old Testament, there is another person named Saul, who is a king.
扫罗的意思就是被要求的。
And Saul, the name Saul means being requested.
因为那个时候以色列人说，人家有王，我们也需要王，所以要撒母耳呢，要安立一个王给他们，就是被要求的意思，就是扫罗。
For Israelite had no king at the time, and they request, made the request to the prophet, asking to appoint a king to lead them. For all other nations, they all had kings.
现在我们知道扫罗变成保罗。
And now we realize the Saul in the New Testament has changed to Paul.
从被要求的变成。
From a person who has been requested, now he is becoming insignificant.
你就看到这个扫罗的生命的改变，从扫罗变成保罗的这个生命的改变，就是这样的出现。
So we realize the person is becoming from Saul to Paul.
你可以想象，这个人物，我们今天看到的伟大的那个保罗。他的生命的谁改变他的生命。
Then let us ponder upon who has changed and made the transformation for Paul's life.
神就是这样改变他。
And this is how God changed his life.
但是神改变他的过程当中用了谁呀？
However, how did God transform Paul's life? Whom did God use?
就是亚拉利亚。
And we realize there's a person called Ananias.
所以今天我们看的过程当中，我们就看到保罗生命的导师是谁。
And right here, we find out Paul had a guide for as part of his transformation.
所以这个保罗这个改变的过程当中，原来就有亚拿尼亚在当中。
So Ananias was part of Paul's transformation.
所以当我们看今天的经文。
As we read the passage from verse 10 to verse 20,
我们就看到这个亚拿尼亚出场的过程当中有一个很特别的情况。
We realize how this character has entered the scene.
明显他是不愿意去做保罗的导师的。
It's very evident that Ananias was quite reluctant of becoming a guide for Paul.
后来他顺服了，然后去见一个他不喜欢的人。
And later on, yet he submit to God to, in order to see a person he did not want to see.
如果你是亚拿尼亚的话
，If you were Ananias,
我相信你都会像他一样跟神理论了。
I believe you too will struggle to refuse to go and see Paul.
这个坏蛋，我们要去帮他。
And this is such an evil person. How should I go and help him out?
但是那个亚拿尼亚顺服了，就这样去。
And yet, Ananias obeyed and submit to God's calling.
但是最重要的是从第十节到十六节当中，十节是一个很重要的一个地方。
And yet, as we see the turning point of the story.Is starting at verse 10.
这里有一个非常特别的地方。
And there is a very particular, peculiar description here.
你看到这个特别的地方吗？
Do you see anything special here?
我们先来看另外两段的经文。
Let us pay attention to two other passages.
也是在使徒行传的第六章。
And it is described in chapter 6.
我们一起来读一下好吗？大众都喜悦这话，就拣选了斯提凡，乃是大有信心、圣灵充满的人。斯提凡猛得恩惠能力，在民间行有大奇事和神迹。好，我们再来看另外第八章的那个一段的经文。
And let us turn to chapter 8, verse 5 to 7.
一起来读哈。腓力撒玛利亚城去，宣讲基督，众人听见了，又看见腓力所行的神迹，就同心合意地听从他的话，因为有许多人被污鬼附着，那些鬼大声呼叫，从他们身上出来，还有许多患的、瘸腿的都得了医治。那这对两段的经文看了。
So we have just read two passages.
跟刚才我们看的这里有什么不同呢？
And what's the difference comparing to the passage we just read at the beginning?
在《使徒行传》第九章第十节就说亚拉利亚是一个门徒。
And right here we realize Ananias is has been described as a disciple.
但是介绍斯提凡呢？
And however, when it the way to describe Philip, Stephen,
很多的东西对吗？
And there were many description when describing the person Stephen.
又有信心，又有灵力啊！
And he is faithful. He is with might.
大神，行大神之。
And he has done great miracles.
腓力也不错啊。
And also when it comes to the person of Philip.
也是说的非常厉害哦。
And he is also an extraordinary man.
但是到了亚拉利亚呢，一个门徒。
And however, when it comes to Ananias, he's merely been described as a disciple.
一个门徒。
And as we see, he's merely a disciple.
就是一个普通的门徒啊。
And he's an ordinary disciple.
你今天如果赵牧师，我问随便他介绍一个弟兄们的姊妹给我认识，他说一个门徒。
And perhaps I'm going to ask Pastor George to introduce me a person in the congregation. I can, and I heard he say, well, he's just a member.
你觉得怎么样？
And how would you feel?
你起码都说他是 AV team 的。
And perhaps you wish to be introduced as, well, he's serving in the audio video team.
他是医学的老师。
And perhaps you want Pastor George say, well, he is a Sunday school teacher.
他是带领敬拜赞美的指挥。
Or he、
啊、
is a worship leader.
对吗？
Isn't it?
我相信他从来没介绍我一个门徒的。
I believe he has never introduced a person to another pastor saying, well, he or she is just a member.
没有这样介绍。
There's no way to make an introduction like this.
但是亚拉利亚。
And however, Ananias has been described as just a disciple.
但是这个一个门徒就执行了一个伟大的工作。
And however, this disciple has executed a great mission.
将我们回到今天的场景当中看的这个保罗是多么伟大的一个使徒。
As we look back, we realize Paul is such a great apostle.
但是现在我们只是看到他是一个门徒。
And however, now we see that Ananias is merely a disciple.
刚才我说金庸小说非常厉害。
As I mentioned before, the author Jin, he is a very clever writer.
他是将角色带入的非常到位。
And he often makes a very vivid description of different characters to the readers.
看到那个射雕英雄传的里面的各证。
As we see, there is a particular novel of his.
他讲话都是结结巴巴的哈。
And one of the main character, he stutter.
很傻的样子。
And he is a very, it looks foolish. innocent and pure, naive. And now we know there are people like that in the church. And sometimes very naive. And perhaps when you read the end of the novel, you realize the main character there, he is very shrewd, he's very clever, and nobody likes him. Sometimes we see the people like that in the church. And if we turn to another novel, we realize there's another character who is very complex. And sometimes he presented as a beggar. And later on, he became a leader. And sometimes we can see such people in the church. And sometimes we can identify such character. Or sometimes we know there is a complex person with a very... He has been through a very complex and complicated situations. And this particular person's teacher turned out to be the one who killed this person's father in the past. And this is a very complex character. As we know, some of the brothers and sisters in the church. As we introduce each other and getting to know each other, we realize some people are relative. And however, those people, they don't talk to each other. And perhaps sometimes we do have street smart. One of the character that he is the friend with the emperor. And perhaps we know somebody like a senator. You realize in this church community, we can identify different characters in the novel. So let us turn our focus into the scripture. We realize when Ananias has been identified as merely a disciple by the author. And yet this ordinary disciple has become the turning point of Paul's life. We can say Ananias is the initial guide for Paul. And therefore, we can get into the third point of today's sermon. How can we learn from the transformation of Paul's life? As we see how Ananias has been very submissive and willing to obey God's calling to go to Paul, he changed Paul's life. From verse 17 to verse 20, we can tell the story. As Ananias went to the house to see a person he detested, he continued to say, I'm going to do this such and such to you. As you can see, he is the agent who has changed Paul's life. Now Paul once again can receive his sight.
吃过饭之后就见证, 就可以进到会堂里面传扬,
After eating, Saul regained his strength and he went to the synagogue, start preaching and proclaiming about Jesus Christ. So as an ordinary disciple, Ananias, he was afraid, for he knew Saul is the person who arrests other Christians to the officials. It is very possible Ananias' name was in Paul's list of arresting. And yet he submits, which is means obeying God's calling and do it. And now he become a transformation agent for Paul to become a new creation. And sometimes he need to remove and lay down his struggle in order to follow God's calling. As he followed Holy Spirit's inspiration and followed through and continued to do. And even he performed baptism for Paul. Can you imagine? A great preacher, a pastor. Can you imagine before his transformation, you were called to baptize that person? Is it great? And as you see, this is a special condition. A person has been baptized and become a great, mighty servant of the Lord. This all begins with an ordinary disciple who is willing to follow God's calling and to baptize him. Through the action of Ananias, he has changed Paul's life. And verse 20 saying, Paul began to preach in the synagogues that Jesus is the Son of God. Not only that, verse 21, that Paul even debate and argue against other Jews. As you can imagine, many Jews, they did not believe that Jesus is the Messiah. And yet, when Paul was praying for 3 days and three nights, he didn't eat anything. From his learning before, as he was educated thoroughly by the Jewish foundation, and he continued to review and reflect upon the things he has learned. As all the Jews were looking for the coming of a Messiah. And yet, out of his expectation, the person turns out to be the one who he persecuted. When he realized the one he encountered on his way is Jesus, Jesus saying that it is difficult for you to kick. As you can imagine, as the person saw who follow a Jewish tradition strictly, and has been overturned as he traveled of his way to Damascus. Of course, he realized that Jesus has been using his 3 years of ministry proclaiming that Jesus is the Messiah.
对他来说,他就对着这些自己的同胞犹太人,傻的,傻的,不要信。
And to Saul, he wants to tell his fellow Jewish people, saying, don't be foolish, don't believe it.
我们犹太人还在等待那个弥赛亚来临啊。
We Jewish should continue to wait for the true Messiah.
不是这个木匠的儿子耶稣所说的这一套的。
It is not this carpenter, the son of carpenter, Jesus.
但是当在那个大光当中,他听到的是什么?我就是耶稣,就是你逼迫的来。Yet,
under the great light, the voice saying, I'm the one who has been persecuted by you, I'm Jesus.
然后在那三天里面不吃不喝的过程当中,
And in these 3 days, without food and drink, Paul continued to ponder and continue to think. And it has been described in the book of Acts, Paul was a student of a great teacher, Galilee, in the Jewish synagogue.
所以这个表示保罗是非常有学问的一个人物,
which means Paul is a scholar who truly know philosophy and history deeply.
他拥有这样的强力的理解, 但是现在一个大马士的路上的经历颠覆了他的思想。
Who has received high education, now through the experience on his way to Damascus, he has been changed.
第九章第21到23节说,他倒过来了,要驳倒那些犹太人。
And as later on in chapter 9, he turned around, he started to argue and debate against other fellow Jews, to prove that Jesus indeed is the Messiah. As we see the 180 degrees transformation,
很像我在上个月去了以色列的时候，我在一个地方叫 Tina National Park的地方看一个地方，
which remind me how I was traveling in Jerusalem last month, Israel last month, and I went to a place.
我到了那个以色列的最南部的一个地方，有一个亭拿那个国家公园。
As I go through the national park of Israel, which is the most southern part of the land, right there is a tabernacle, model of tabernacle being built with the exact proportion. Now the travel guide told us that he is a Jew. I am the Jew who believe in Messiah. Messianic Jew. And what does it mean, Messianic Jew?
的犹太人。
Which means the Jew who believe in Jesus Christ is the Messiah.
哇，那天我们看着他介绍那个祭坛。
As that day he started to describe the meaning of the altar to us.
又有那个洗桌盘。
And also the washing basin.
那又有那个陈切饼。
And also the table of the bread.
又有那个金灯台。
And also the golden lampstand.
哇，那个香炉。
And also the incense holder.
那还有那个大祭司的那个袍啊、胸牌啊这些。
And also the robe of a priest.
那进到至圣所里面有约柜。
As we enter the Holy of the Holy, we see the Ark of Covenant.
我们几个人看着他在介绍这些的时候。
As we see this travel guide introducing us to the place.
我觉得整个过程好像给人不一样。
And to me, I feel I was in the revival meeting.
为什么这样说呢？
Or why I say that?
同保罗差不多。
Because he's much like Paul.
保罗跟他也是犹太人嘛。
Paul just like him. Is a Jew.
改变之后就相信耶稣是谁。
And now, after transformation of Paul, Paul now believes Jesus is the Son of God, who is Messiah. Also, this travel guide, the same way, in the past, he was an Orthodox Jew, so everything he described was part of his life. As his fathers told him every item in the ark and the tabernacle, the meaning of every single article, it's all for the purpose of longing for the coming of Messiah. The only difference between this person and his forefathers is that he now believes Jesus is Messiah. And yet his forefathers or relatives were still waiting for the coming of Messiah. And yet this person now has accepted Jesus is the Savior. As he described every article in the tabernacle, he was telling us that all this article representing and is a foreshadow of coming of Jesus. As we see the excitement of as he was speaking, and just like the way how was talking about the novels I mentioned before. Perhaps I can talk about an elder Chinese festival or about a folk tale of Chinese stories.
Moon
Festival. Or the origin of mooncake. And oftentimes as we talk about the mooncake or the different Chinese tradition, we are very excited. And just like the way we did, this person has a lot of story to tell. And his mood and his emotion, just like Paul, he can turn every article and the meaning behind them to point to Jesus. And to us who were standing around him, we feel we are going through an evangelistic meeting. Today, as we are brothers and sisters, that today we are just like one ordinary disciple.
但是我们对这个
And yet, are we able to tell the things we believe? Today, as we come before the Lord, can we identify ourselves into the scripture? Today, Ananias is merely a disciple. No matter what positions or responsibility you are taking in the church, you are also merely a member, a disciple. As we are an ordinary disciple, can we do some extraordinary thing? Can we use our life to become the agent of the transformation of another due to our submission to the Lord? If today God is calling a disciple among us, will we respond to God saying no, no, no? And we see this is the initial response from Ananias. And yet, what happened after that? He submit to the Lord by faith. Today, the same way God has some mission for us to do. Let us not look down on ourselves. Do not think we were merely a disciple. God likes to use an ordinary person. Let us pray. Dear Lord Jesus, as we listen to your words, we know you have words to say to us. You want to use us as an ordinary disciple, just the way how you have used Ananias. And Lord, may you change our life to change other people's life, so that people's life can become a shining torch among others. And Lord, give us obedient heart so that we can have faith in you. And Lord, may you help us to follow your words. We pray in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.